Unfortunately, about a quarter of people with epilepsy also have depression, which can be worsened by certain anti-seizure medications like Keppra that is commonly used. Fortunately, we have an anti-seizure medicine that can treat both epilepsy and depression at the same time. It is lamotrigine. Let's talk about lamotrigine for epilepsy and other conditions, and make sure to stick until the end where I tell you how I use myself lamotrigine in the epilepsy clinic and what are the best cases to be given for. I am Dr. Omar Danoon, an epileptologist and epilepsy specialized neurologist. And on this channel, I'll talk all about epilepsy in an easy way that everyone can understand and still provide high value information from the expert. I will answer these 10 questions about lamotrigine today. What types of epilepsy lamotrigine treats? What other conditions are treated by lamotrigine? How does lamotrigine work? How to dose lamotrigine? What to do if lamotrigine is not working for me? What are the side effects of lamotrigine? How does lamotrigine interact with contraceptive and birth control? Can I drive or drink alcohol with lamotrigine? How to stop lamotrigine if it's not working for me? Is lamotrigine safe in pregnancy and breastfeeding? I just want to remind you that this video is for information only and is not intended to replace qualified medical judgment. First question, what types of epilepsy lamotrigine treats? Lamotrigine is considered a broad-spectrum anti-seizure drug. It treats both focal epilepsy and generalized epilepsy. The only concern is that it can worsen myoclonic jerks in juvenile myoclonic epilepsy and generalized epilepsies, which honestly I don't see as much in practice. Lamotrigine is FDA approved for adjuvant treatment, which means add-on, for focal seizures and for generalized tonic-clonic seizures. And it is approved for adults and for children age 2 and above, for both primary generalized epilepsy and Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. However, the AAN, American Academy of Neurology guidelines recommend the use of lamotrigine as a treatment for newly diagnosed both focal seizures and generalized tonic-clonic seizures. A recent study in 2021 compared lamotrigine to zonisamide and levetiracetam. It found that it is better than both of these two medications as a first line in terms of efficacy, cost, and quality of life. What other conditions are treated by lamotrigine? Lamotrigine is a good medication that can treat multiple other conditions such as bipolar disorder, depression, obsessive compulsive disorder or OCD, and trigeminal neuralgia. How does lamotrigine work? The exact mechanism is still unknown. However, we know it works by inhibiting the excitatory neurotransmitter GABA that is responsible for increasing the electricity in the brain via blocking the voltage-gated sodium channels. Also, it inhibits the glutamate release, kind of stops the electricity from going too much in the brain. How to dose lamotrigine? Lamotrigine is available as tablets only with no IV or liquid forms. Lamotrigine dosing is a little tricky. Our aim is to slowly introduce the medicine to the body to avoid a rare but serious skin allergic reaction called Stevens-Johnson syndrome. We aim for a treatment dose of 200 to 500 mg daily, likely in two divided doses. Because lamotrigine is processed in the liver, it interacts with other medications and anti-seizure drugs. That is why we have three titration schedules to make sure we account for all of these interactions. First, when it is not combined with any other liver-inducing or inhibiting drugs, we start 25 mg daily and titrate to reach 100 mg twice a day following this schedule. When it is combined with valproate, which is an enzyme inhibitor, meaning that it decreases the liver processing and metabolism of the drugs and clears the lamotrigine slowly, in that situation, we use a slower schedule. We start 25 mg every other day and titrate based on this schedule. When it is combined with enzyme-inducing medications such as carbamazepine, phenytoin, or rifampin, which makes the liver process lamotrigine faster, we start with 25 mg twice a day this time and follow a faster titrating schedule like this one. In case of liver and kidney failure, we decrease the final dose of lamotrigine due to decreased processing and metabolism. If this video is of value to you, please hit the like button to spread to more people. Thank you. What to do if lamotrigine is not working for me? There are many reasons why an anti-seizure medication might not work for you. People usually give up too early or on a too low of a dose. First reason is non-compliance. Missing a dose of lamotrigine can lead to breakthrough seizures, and you should not miss any dose of lamotrigine. If you miss a dose, you should make it up right away during the day. And if you miss it the whole day, you should double the dose at night so that you keep a steady level in the blood. So anti-seizure medications are not like cholesterol medications, which you can forget here and there and still be fine. Second, make sure you are on a high enough dose. And third, give it enough time to work. Around 3 to 6 months, that is the usual recommendation. You can add another medication or switch to something else. Or you might be having what we call drug-resistant epilepsy, which is happening in about 25% of people with epilepsy, that they do not respond good to treatments. And in that patient population, we sometimes use surgical treatments, which we will talk about in a later video. What are the side effects of lamotrigine? Common side effects include gastrointestinal effects like abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and it can cause dizziness, double vision, and tremors. And it can worsen myoclonic gyrus, as we mentioned before. Skin rash is also a common side effect, and the medicine should be stopped if this happens. And there are some more serious skin reactions called Stevens-Johnson syndrome with skin ulcers. There is a new FDA warning regarding potential cardiac conduction issues in the electricity of the heart and slowing of the ventricular conduction and widening of the QRS, especially in cardiac channelopathy such as Brugada syndrome, kind of fancy names of the problems of the conduction in the heart. How does lamotrigine interact with contraceptives and birth control pills? We know that oral contraceptive pills containing estrogen or estrogen implants such as vaginal rings can decrease the levels of lamotrigine, so the dose should be adjusted accordingly. Can I drive or drink alcohol with lamotrigine? Initially, lamotrigine can cause dizziness and drowsiness, so it is recommended to avoid driving when you feel drowsy until you get used to the medication, which happens with time. Alcohol should be avoided with lamotrigine because of the worsening of dizziness and drowsiness. How to stop lamotrigine if it's not working for me? Lamotrigine, like other anti-seizure drugs, should not be stopped abruptly. It should be slowly tapered down over a few weeks to prevent the withdrawal seizures. We only stop it abruptly in case of a severe allergic reaction. Is lamotrigine safe in pregnancy and breastfeeding? Yes, lamotrigine is one of the safest medications in pregnancy and breastfeeding. I have a detailed video on epilepsy treatment during pregnancy and breastfeeding that I will link to in the description below. Now, understanding all of these properties of this great medication, I use lamotrigine in new onset seizures, in girls and women of childbearing age, due to the excellent safety in pregnancy. It works great for any person with epilepsy, along with depression, anxiety, bipolar disorder, or any psychiatric conditions. It works very well for epilepsy in the elderly, and usually in this population, we use a lower dose for better tolerability, and it is a stimulating for those patients, so it does not make them sleepy like other medications. Honestly, if it did not have skin rash and was available in IV form, it would be the one medication for all. And to get the best treatment for epilepsy as a whole, I put together 10 tips for you to follow to best control your seizures that you can see in this video. And stay healthy, and see you in the next one.